Hello everyone, this is our second lecture of the ratio analysis. In earlier lecture, we have studied all the formulas of the profitability ratio and liquidity ratio. Now, all this using that formula, we are solving the one sum, the illustration number one. The balance sheet of the Mukund Iron Limited as on 31st March 2013 is as under. The liability and asset is given. Additional information: sales 30 lakh, in which case sales is 25% credit of the credit sales. Gross profit 7,50,000. Net profit before debenture interest and 50% tax 4,33,500. Calculate the following ratio: gross profit ratio, net profit ratio, current ratio, liquid ratio, debtors ratio and proprietary ratio. In today's lecture, we are only showing the four basic ratios. Debtor ratio and proprietary ratio we will solve in the later. So let's start with the sum. So first ratio we have to calculate is gross profit ratio. As we all know, the formula of the gross profit ratio is equals to gross profit divided by sales into 100, right? Gross profit is given 7,50,000 into sales is given, total sales is 30 lakh. We do not have to bifurcate in the gross profit ratio how much is cash or how much is credit. The credit sale we require for the debtors ratio, then we will discuss later. Now we are to show the only sales, total sales, not the cash, not the credit sales. Total sale will be 30 lakh into 100. 7,50,000 divided by 30 lakh into 100, that is 25%. Gross profit ratio is equals to 25%. What does that mean? That means out of the total sale, we have a profit ratio of the 25%. So after 30 lakh of rupees, we are getting 25% of profit, right? Now, second is net profit ratio. Net profit ratio is equals to net profit divided by sales into 100. The net profit is given. Yes, it's given. Net profit. But 4,33,500. But it is a before debenture interest and tax. So we have to first deduct the debenture interest, then we will deduct the tax. The sequence will be same. You cannot first deduct tax or then dividend, right? Sorry, interest. So first we have to compulsory deduct debenture interest. What is the amount of interest? That is not given. So we have to find out. 9% debenture of rupees 1,50,000. So interest will be 1,50,000 into 9%. So 1,50,000 into 9%. Interest will come 13,500. We get 4,20,000 profit before tax, right? Now we are deducting tax. 50%, so 4,20,000 into 50%, 2,10,000. We get profit after tax is equals to 2,10,000, right? So total net profit will be 2,10,000. So directly applying in the formula, net profit will be 2,10,000 divided by sales. Sales is 30 lakh into 100. right? So net profit percentage is 7%. The gross profit ratio would be 25% and net profit ratio is 7%, right? Now let's solve the third ratio. Current ratio. For the current ratio, what is the formula of the current ratio? Current asset divided by current liability. So first we have to calculate all the current asset and all the current liabilities, right? So let's solve it. Current assets and current liabilities. First, let's check out the asset side. Land and building is not a current asset. Plant and machinery is not a current asset. Debtors, right? So it's a current asset. Debtors, 1,80,000. Then stock is also current asset, 1,20,000. Bills receivable, 20,000. And bank balance, 80,000. Let's total it out. 1,80,000 plus 1,20,000 plus 20,000 plus 80,000. Total is 4,00,000. Now current liability. Equity share, preference share, reserve and surplus are not a current asset. 9% debenture, it's a long term liability, so it's a not a current liability. Sorry. Let's start with the creditors. 1,50,000. Bills payable, 40,000. Outstanding expense, 30,000. And workman profit sharing fund, 30,000. Total of the current liability will be 1,50,000 plus 40,000 plus 30,000 plus 30,000. 2,50,000. Right? Now we have a current asset as well as current liability. So current ratio is equals to current asset divided by current liability. Current asset will be 4,00,000 divided by 2,50,000. It will come 1.6. 1.6. As we all know, the profitability ratio always state in the percentage, while liquidity ratio in the form of simple figure. Just like we have to find out 1.6 is to 1. Right? So current ratio will be 1.6 is to 1. So out of the current liability we have a more current assets. Now fourth one, liquid ratio. So now what was the formula of the liquid ratio? Liquid asset divided by liquid liability. So first we have to find out the liquid asset. So liquid asset is equals to current asset minus stock. Current asset was total 4,00,000. Minus stock value is 1,20,000, 4 lakh minus 1,20,000, 2,80,000. So liquid asset will be 2,80,000. Now calculate the liquid liabilities. So liquid liabilities is equals to current liability minus bank OD. In the our sum there is a no bank overdraft, right? So we are direct write 2,50,000 minus zero, that means 2,50,000 liquid liability. So put in the formula, liquid ratio is equals to liquid assets divided by liquid liabilities. So liquid asset 2,80,000 upon 2,50,000. So it is a 1.12:1 liquidity ratio. So 1.12:1. Understood? Now we are studying the leverage ratios. In leverage ratio, first is proprietary ratio. What do you mean by the proprietary ratio? That means the out of the business whole liability there is a enough capital or a proprietor's fund enough for the out of that total fund. What are the proportion in the owner's fund and the outside liabilities, right? So proprietary ratio is equals to proprietor's fund upon total funds in 200. So what include in the proprietor's fund? It includes the paid up capital and reserve and surplus. So proprietor funds is equals to paid up capital plus reserve and surplus, right? Second is debt equity ratio. Debt equity ratio shows that relationship between debt and equity. How much debt is there for the business and what are the exact equities fund. Equity funds is available in the business. So debt equity ratio is equals to long term liabilities upon shareholders funds. And this ratio, when its ratio come higher, that means the outside creditor have a larger claim than owners of the business. Then that means we have to pay outside liability more. But is a, when the portion in the profit is a less, just because it's a fixed and we have to pay it at the, we are using a more outside cap debt than equity. So ratio would be profit sharing ratio would be lower in the debt equity ratio. So it's a beneficial to this ratio will become higher. And if it is a lower, that it not a profitable for the viewpoint of the equity shareholders, right? So it will divide into more terms, right? the major part of the equity, there is a division of the profit, will be larger, that will be not beneficial for the equity shareholders, right? Then third is capital gearing ratio. Capital gearing ratio shows that the how much profit out of the profit we have to paid outside and how efficient for that, right? So what are the expenses as over the capital we are purchasing from the outside and we have to paid it, just like example we are taking the loans, so we have to pay back in payback, and also we have to pay interest, right? And if we are getting our bonds or debentures, so we have to pay the dividends, right? So what are the capital gearing ratio out of we have a total profit, so proportion of that and that effect on the our capital, right? So gearing ratio is equals to fixed interest plus dividend divided by ordinary capital. Here dividend refers to the only dividend payable to the preference share holders, right? Now let's move further. Fourth one, long term funds to fixed asset ratio. As the formula is given in the name itself, so long term funds divided by fixed assets. What is the meaning of that ratio? The ratio shows the relationship between the long term funds are invested in the fixed asset. So asset out of the asset mortgage we can pay the long term funds, right? It will give the relationship between the long term funds and fixed asset. Long term funds includes share capital plus reserve and surplus plus long term liabilities. Right? Fifth, interest coverage ratio. Interest coverage ratio is equals to profit before interest and tax. We have to write like EBIT, interest before interest and tax. Short form is EBIT upon interest. Out of the total earning or the total profit, what is the proportion of the interest that we have to paid outside? That's known as interest coverage ratio. So profit before interest and tax divided by interest, total interest payable to the outside. There is a sub part of this coverage ratio also, that is total coverage ratio. Total coverage ratio. Total coverage ratio is equals to EBIT divided by interest plus dividend plus installment. All the outside interest or dividend to the preference shareholders or installment payable in what is the proportion of that out of the profit. That shows the total coverage ratio, that out of the profit how much part of that profit we have to paid outside, right? So it is a total coverage ratio. Understood? With the helping of this leverage ratio, we are solving the sums in the next lecture. Thank you.